We had someone who is important to the hockey community. He signed off for the final time in Mike Doc Emrick, one of the most iconic announcers, broadcasters. He really changed the game for how to announce hockey. You know, a voice for all teams. It was one of the more interesting things was that as he announced his retirement, it was like every team was posting their own, like his best calls for our team sort of thing, which is just like astounding that, you know, he touched so many different fan bases and he was kind of this one unifying figure in hockey.
As being a Devil fan, obviously I have to give my salute to Doc Emrick because before, you know, he was that, you know, NBC Sports national commentator. He was with the Devils for, I think, over 2 decades. And he was the voice of the Devils. And he made the experience of watching games absolutely amazing. A time was when we went to the Stanley Cup, unfortunately lost to the Kings. But, you know, that series before, as I said, the Rangers, game 6, you know, his voice when Henrique scored and, you know, he just screaming, Henrique, it's over. And then people going crazy. Zooms in on Lundqvist's sad face. It was amazing. You know, Ryan McDonough puts his head down and it was just like an incredible time and just hearing his call for that moment.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't think that moment would be as special if it wasn't for him calling it. So, you know, thank you for that, Doc. If you are watching this or ever comes by, thank you for everything you've done for the Devils, for hockey and, you know, making this sport special for myself.
Well, obviously, you know, I'm not going to sugarcoat it as an Islanders fan. I didn't get too much Doc in my life, but
not a lot of nationally televised.
But listen, not too many playoffs. but I do think that part of why, you know, I always will argue time and time again that Stanley Cup playoffs are the best playoffs ever in sports history, and that is, you know, like largely in part that Doc makes it so fun to watch a hockey game, so exciting. Like, you know, obviously minutes, the seconds before a goal is scored, you're already like, you know, on your the edge of your seat. It's gonna be missed, but I think that Brendan Burke, Ithaca College grad, Islanders announcer, play by play, he's gonna be, you know, up there
cool
soon.
Well, as a new fan, I obviously missed out on Doc, but as I go back to watch some old Rangers highlights, I've heard his voice and I'll get more and more familiar with his iconic calls. But yeah, it was really cool to just see like a unifying figure in hockey gets, you know, his flowers from everyone. And oftentimes people don't get their flowers until it's too late, but it was nice that every team in some way or another had a way to reach out and congratulate him on an amazing career. And I'm glad we got an opportunity to do the same. So I think that's going to be it today for the Thin Ice podcast. You know, you can catch us on all places you listen to podcasts, Apple, Spotify, SoundCloud, etc. Thanks again, Aly and Matt, for taking some time out to talk hockey. It's nice to finally do this in a podcast style, and I'm sure we'll be doing it plenty more. And, you know, you can always keep up with us on Concrete New York on Instagram and Twitter and Facebook. And we'll be posting a whole lot more about hockey as we get closer to whatever that potential start date is. So,
for sure.
Thanks again, and we'll be in touch soon.
Go Devils.
Islanders.
Awesome.